Angels, Los Angeles, California.
Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Los Angeles Chargers and their Southern California rivals, the Los Angeles Rams.
And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
To throw is Stafford.
And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Maybe a little over-anxious in the pocket there. He just didn't look comfortable on that throw.
No, he didn't, because it wasn't his normal fluid delivery. And I think you might have had it right. Wasn't really confident with what he saw downfield and almost felt like he wanted to pull that one back.
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw complete there to Beckham. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
A big play there on the catch and run.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10.
First and 10. Play action. Stafford rolling to his left. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
That's up number. First down.
Now the first carry for Cam Akers.
The tackle made there by Linval Joseph.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Stafford's throw, it's complete into the hands of Higbee.
And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 13-yard line.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Flushed out right. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Derwin James with a pick.
And the Chargers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback. And they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10
at their own 20-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Austin Ekeler. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. That's complete to Austin Ekeler, the running back. And all the way down to the 36-yard line. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Back to throw here, Herbert. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 17. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35.
Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both...
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Kenneth Murray charging hard from that linebacker spot, and he drops him for a loss of 11.
Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21.
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted.
Picked off at the 15. And his guys will take over at the 14-yard line in the red zone.
And not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now two interceptions thrown.
Well, the good ones, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the two interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
Eluding the pressure right. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them.
And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown.
Austin Eckler there to make the grab. And the Chargers are on the board first on the road here in L.A.
Extra point good by Hopkins. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Dustin Hopkins set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Back to throw, Stafford. That'll be caught. It's Kupp. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Throwing again on second and 10. Stafford. This is caught. It's Woods. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 26-yard line. Got a man, it's Higbee complete. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against him a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Throwing again at Stafford. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. That catch good for only a couple.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
Flush to his right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
7th play of the drive, forthcoming on 3rd and 8. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They're going to go for it now, 4th and 2. Remember, they can still get the first down at the 1 yard line, though. Escaping the pressure right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read, and it's picked off. He's at the 50. 30. 10. 5. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Well, you don't want to coach him, Charles, to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play, and making a bad throw. It turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
This fielded right at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early. to let him get settled back in.
But they told us they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
He'll get about four here down to the 43-yard line. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. Flushed out right. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually. And they'll hold on to the football as well. Third and two, Stafford. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Here we go on fourth, Stafford. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
First and 10.
Now a play fake at Stafford. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. So no gain on the play, and it'll be second and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Stafford going to give to Akers on the draw. And he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he needed. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. Stafford will stay out there. He'll lead his guys up to go for it on fourth down. Now they go for it on fourth down, but that pass is knocked away and incomplete. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And the Charger defense stands tall and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. They have been red hot, sometimes white hot here in this first half. They're just looking to add to that total right now.
And this has to serve as a reminder to myself because so many times I get wrapped up in the play calling, how they've sequenced things, how it's run. But you know, at the end of the day, it's still execution. Those guys out on the field, and right now they are locked in and really looking good.
They'll try to continue to be locked in here as we get ready to approach halftime. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, LA.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly...
Oh, look at this! A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. He's at the 50. The 30. 10, five, and can you believe this? It's 2 points the other way on the fumble return.
Dustin Hopkins set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
Powell now to take it out of the end zone.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the... And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Derwin James with a pick. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. Well, Charles, he's thrown five picks in a game before, and right now, after that one, he's standing on number four.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offensive coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field, so play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more, but a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
You got three.
Herbert takes it and just pops it forward.
And this is going to be a Charger touchdown.
Keenan Allen with a touchdown reception from Justin Herbert. And the Chargers are able to add on to their first half lead. And they'll have Herbert try and throw for it.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Taylor Rapp with a pick.
Well, there's some excitement, right? Go for two, and instead it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give them a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the troops rallied.
Exactly, and getting back there, making the tackle, and not giving up 2 points themselves.
Powell now to take it out of the end zone.
And he's going to be out of bounds on the return. Not a great return. They'll start back around the 17. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
And with a three-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive.
Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Back again up in this. Entertain it for you. Come for my M's, you get this double, double.
Or so southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Los Angeles Rams and their Southern California rivals, the Los Angeles Chargers. Dustin Hopkins set to get this one going. And we are underway in Southern California.
And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That catch good for five. It's third down. Now Stafford. Flush to his right. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play and gave up a bigger one instead.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Now Stafford. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. The Chargers grab the 7-0 lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Going up top for Kupp, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. And he'll find his target, Woods. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They'll run on first down with Akers. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Joey Bosa so strong, able to fight his way in there to make the play. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. Throwing on third down, Stafford. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. First down, Akers. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple, down to the 19.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
That's a big league job there of getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
They'll run here with Akers. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Stafford.
being chased out left. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Matthew Stafford. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Here's Roberts to bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. And he finds his man. It's the former Ram, Jared Cook. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Play action. It's Herbert. It's complete to Cook. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Herbert off of play action. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to fire one. Corner of the end zone. He finds his receiver, Williams, for a Charger touchdown. Mike Williams, 34 yards. And the Chargers have taken the lead. Hopkins with the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. To throw is Stafford. Flushed out right. Well, that'll be caught by Kump. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. On the give, this is Akers. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter. 14-7. Second and 9. Stafford. And his throw here is incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Stafford down to throw. Eluding the pressure right.
Well, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. And they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
And all the way down to the 22-yard line. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Flush to his right. This is caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds.
First and goal at the 2-yard line.
Trying to punch it in with Eckler. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler. Taking it in from 2 yards out. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. Extra point good by Hopkins. And it's now 21-7. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
Powell now to take it out of the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions.
Touchdown, LA! Cooper Kupp, 78 yards. And the Rams get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Here's Roberts to bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Charger drive about to get going. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And got his man complete. A big play there just before halftime. Herbert on first down now. Flushed out right. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Leonard Floyd. And the Rams are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. The final shot before the break. Stafford. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So the offense, a little antsy, the flag comes out, and a 5-yard penalty. Final shot before break. Stafford going up top for Kupp. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
Both these teams no doubt making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gutten and Charles Davis.
And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. Eluding the press. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way into the backfield. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. And this is Cook with the grab. A crazy sequence here. A huge gain that time, but it still leaves him well short for fourth down.
They snap it to Herbert. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Rams get the football in outstanding field position. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. A quick throw caught by Kopp out wide. That catch good for only a couple. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8. Off the fake to Akers, here's Stafford. Rush coming and he's taken down. Kenneth Murray gets him for a loss of 10 yards from his linebacker spot. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
They snap it to Stafford. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. Herbert's throw taken in by Cook. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
On first down, Justin Herbert. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Herbert operating from the red zone. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. Easy to tell who they're targeting on this drive. He caught the first two passes, but then this time unable to hook up.
But I don't think that that stops them from continuing to go back to him, do you?
No.
I mean, they've got a plan. They're trying to execute it.
And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen with a touchdown reception from Justin Herbert. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Powell now to take it out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Escaping the pressure right. His throw incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Stafford looks to throw again. And Woods has it complete. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. Back to throw, Stafford. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball. But surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Three quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first down at Stafford. Going right back to Beckham here, complete. Not much there, only a yard. And we're at the 41, second and 9. Now Stafford. Throw left side, complete to Kupp. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 25-yard line. Again, it's Stafford. Caught left side, it's Beckham. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. From the gun, here's Stafford. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Michael Davis. Now the ball comes loose. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defense is talking about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. Exactly right. A lost opportunity.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing. Just chucked. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. Cooper Kupp, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
Rams 21.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Charger drive about to get going. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
To throw again on second down, Herbert. He dumps it to Eckler underneath. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams' 31-yard line. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. And the Rams are right back in this football game. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter, turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak, not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
On second and 11 now. Stafford flushed out right.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatlining, leveling everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Stafford. He'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Meanwhile, Stafford's throw, it's complete into the hands of Higbee. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Rolling to his right. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Now Stafford. That's out to the flat for Akers. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now it's Stafford. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Michael Davis. And the Chargers have just about sewn up this football game.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Herbert. That is caught. It's Williams. The 20. And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels. And that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Well, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively.